Hello, welcome back to Ture TV. I pray you are well and I pray you are doing great. If this is your first time, please don't forget to subscribe, like and share the videos for the benefit of others. Today I would like to talk about 10 shocking facts about Nigeria and Ghana. And number one on my list today is the government of both countries. You see, the Nigerian government does not care about the welfare of its citizens, neither does it care about the country. The presidency does not care about addressing the nation on latest developments. During the COVID-19 pandemic, many leaders in Africa have been addressing their nations and their people with regards to the pandemic and the steps they want to take. But in Nigeria, the reverse is the case. People had to beg the president for him to come out and address the people. On the other hand, in Ghana, the president was always addressing the nation on the steps he took in order to bring the coronavirus to a halt. Number two, the roads in Nigeria does not last for more than 15 years. And I personally don't know of any road in Nigeria which lasts more than 30 years. You take the same border, for instance, like in this video that you're about to watch. The road has been dilapidated for over 20 years now, and that road happens to be a West African road. That's the ECOWAS road, and headquarters is in Nigeria here. Yet look at the road, the state of the road. Even though the government is trying to do something, but the time that it took for the road to be rehabilitated is more than 20 years as I speak now. And when you look at other roads which link West African countries in other countries like Benin Republic, Togo, down to Ghana and Ivory Coast and others, you see the road network is very, very good. When it comes to Nigeria, the reverse is the case. But when you take the roads in Ghana, when you take the motorway, for instance, motorway was built by the first president of Ghana during his tenure. That's of surgery for Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, and up till date, the road is still functioning. When you take the Kanda Highway as well, it's also built, it was built during the region Rawlings time, and up till date, the road is still functioning. It's in good condition. But when you take the road linking Enugu State and Anambra State, the condition of the road is very, very terrible, most especially during rainy season. Number three on our list is electricity. The government, the Nigerian government, prefers to sell its gas to Ghana for Ghana to produce electricity for our citizens. Meanwhile, Nigeria and Nigerians had to suffer in darkness. And those who can afford it should go power generators in order to be able to power their houses and their business. Number four on our list is the education sector in Nigeria is very poor, to the extent some Nigerians who can afford to take their children to other countries do take their children to Ghana and elsewhere for good quality education, which means the education in Ghana, the education sector in Ghana is better than the education sector in Nigeria, and they don't hesitate to take their children out of the country for good quality education. Number five on our list, tribalism. This is the major problem facing the country now, Nigeria, tribalism and religion. Tribalism and religion plays a very significant role in everyday activity of every Nigerian. To the extent the only time you see Nigerians united is when the country is playing in the African Cup of Nations, or when they are about to bash Ghana on the jollof rice. That's the only time you see Nigerians united. But other than that, there's nothing like unity among Nigerians. And Nigerians are highly tribalistic. But when you get to Ghana, you can hardly find out who is who, because nobody cares about who you are. All they know is they are Ghanaians and nothing more than that. Security or security personnel is the number six on our list. The Nigerian security personnel do not have a very good relationship with Nigerians. It was the lack of good relationship which led to the NSAS protest in Nigeria. Meanwhile, on the other hand, when you get to Ghana, the security personnel and the citizens get together easily. No one looks down on the other, and the civilians do respect the security personnel of Ghana because they respect themselves. Number seven on our list is bribery and corruption. Nigerian security personnel do extort money from motorists on Nigerian roads at their checkpoints before they allow some drivers to pass. Instead of doing their job diligently, they prefer to collect money and allow people to pass with whatever they are carrying. Meanwhile, in Ghana, they don't do like that. Even if they do, I'm not saying Ghana isn't corrupt as well. Ghana is corrupt as well. But the level of corruption in Ghana compared to Nigeria is insipid. Insipid, totally insipid. Based on comparison wise, number eight is corruption. Nigerians who sat before a corruption panel or an investigation panel investigating them based on their corruptions can easily faint, and that will be the end of the investigation. The charges will be dropped and they will never be called again for the corruption charges to be continued, or the investigation to be continued. Meanwhile, on the other hand, I've never seen something like that in Ghana happening, where government officials who have been charged or who are under investigation for corruption charges easily faint for the investigation to be stopped or to be stalled. Number nine, lawlessness. Nigerians are highly lawless. A simple instruction, just like a traffic light, when the red light goes on, instead of people to stop, you see them passing because everybody's in a hurry. And when you take Ghana for instance, Ghanaians do follow the law, at least to the maximum of their ability. When a traffic light is red, they do stop. Even though some people might not stop, they do pass. And some places in Nigeria do follow the law as well. But the rate at which they do abide by the law, on a percentage wise, is too low. That's number nine. And number 10 is healthcare. The healthcare system in Nigeria currently is beyond expectation for a country as Nigeria, with the resources and the wealth which is being displayed by Nigerians outside Nigeria and in Nigeria, that's within Nigeria, to be having such bad healthcare system is a shameful thing totally to Nigeria. To the extent now most Nigerians do go to Ghana for good quality healthcare service. So without wasting much of your time, this is a 10 bitter truth between Nigeria and Ghana. I will be bringing more. Until next time, we are together.